Again, social, not so, maybe for women, because women, as women, they are easier to start conversations or to have friends. It's women can friend any woman anywhere under any circumstances, it's easier. But still, it's a challenge here. Because most of the time, when you find the woman walking with her, pushing her the stroller, you find her with other friends. Or when she go with the fika with other women that she have met, maybe in the yoga class or in the gym, when they have this mama time for where the mother go with the children for exercising small babies. So she got to know them, so they go to this fika time. Or because they are relatives, and sometimes the women try to synchronize the pregnancy at the same time with their friends or relatives, so they are having their maternity leave together. Maternity leave is another big thing in Sweden. This is something we are going to discuss, because anyone who have been in Sweden, then when they come and say, oh, why are all these women pushing strollers? Yeah, because a man has paternity leave and he has to share and he has to take these days with the woman. Yes, Sweden is very generous, 450 days for maternity leave that is being split between the mother and the father. But this is another thing for another episode. So going back to the social thing, as we said, men, lots of interviews and studies has been, and surveys has been done for foreigners who came to Sweden and asking them about their social life. They say more than 70% say that they hardly have any Swedish friend. Some of them say, yeah, we have colleagues. Sometimes we go and celebrate in certain occasions through work. Some other people, they say, oh yeah, we have a friend, but we wouldn't say they are friends. We can say more of their colleagues. But as I mentioned, you have to be lucky to have people who want to be meeting people from another countries. They are so much interested to listen, by the way. They are extremely good listener and they are very sympathetic and very empathetic. But the thing is, for them to have the idea of the friendship, it's a big thing. It's a responsibility. Another thing I think, and as I said, this is a politically incorrect video. So the last 10 years there was a real rise in the crime in Sweden, and unfortunately it was according to different studies, it was immigrants who had committed most of these crimes, especially the serious crimes is being committed by foreigners or immigrants. So we can say that the right wing has been trashing the immigrants big time. So of course, if you are being bombarded by the news every single day about this immigrant coming from this country has done this, this person has murdered this, this person has raped, and of course the rape here is a big thing. Of course anyone should be intolerant. In all countries they are intolerant towards rape, but so of course rape is intolerant and unacceptable in any country, but in Sweden, it's worse than murder, I can say. Remember, feminism is a big thing here in Sweden. So anything patriarchy, the idea of the man being the macho, the masculinity culture, it's intolerable in Sweden. And maybe this is one of the reasons why the men doesn't feel that they have the status here. Of course, we have in different lots of countries, the man has a certain status, has certain prestige, has a certain power. In Sweden, he doesn't have it. You enter the airport, you drop this masculinity in the airport. It's not there. No one will tolerate it. Even your male colleagues will never praise anything anti-feminist you're trying to do. Remember that Sweden is the first country in the world that has now a feminist government. So yeah, you can sit and brood and imagine. So women status here, or feminism movement, or women, the woman empowerment here is a big thing in the culture. So lots of men feel threatened because of this. You can have your, not only that your line managers can be women, but Women has a real power here, and they will never, never accept any shit from any man at all. As this word when they say, if they are not happy with a man, they don't say, we will not divorce. They say, we will throw you out. So that's why when it can be very difficult for a man to meet a Swedish woman, because the idea of equality that is still doesn't exist in lots of men culture or mentality. But this again, the thing with marriage is another thing, but we have to put this in consideration, the thing of with the woman movement. Another thing here that maybe also the social aspect maybe in this, in some countries you can be feeling the pride or the power or the status again. But in Sweden, there is this phrase or idiom or proverb that say, you are nothing, you are no one, don't think that you are better than anyone. So if the prime minister was in a queue in ICA supermarket, no one will give him his spot to go first and buy something. No one will do this. He is just an employee in the government who happens to be the prime minister. If you have, of course, by then your boss in IKEA or Volvo or wherever, he can be washing his cup of coffee after he finish it, or rinse it and put it in the dishwasher. No one will come, oh sir, no, we will come and fix it for you. This is not there. So maybe this is also another thing that made some people not comfortable. They don't have feel this special status. You are like anyone. You pay taxes, you have the same rights, you have the same laws applied on you. If you try to put a little bit, a stash of pride over anything, oh my God, you'll find the other face of the Swede. And the other face is really, really, really tough. And there is this final point I want to talk about the social aspect. Sometimes the status of the family. In your family, is a small family or big family, you can be having a certain status that you are coming from this certain family or this certain social class, or your relatives work in this sector in the government, and they will facilitate things for you, or you will pick up the phone and call this person to fix you the problem. It's not here. It doesn't exist. And this is maybe also another thing that make some people who come to Sweden a little bit comfortable, because they don't feel that they have any power. All the power is with the government. It's not with the relatives, it's not with the friends, it's not with anyone except the government and themselves. So again, the social aspect in Sweden is a big, big thing. And for you to come and think to move to Sweden, you have to know that you are a kind of person who can adapt to this. And also, this is the final bit for the social thing here in this episode, is that the idea that you can be living in a place that maybe only 100 people living in a neighborhood with only one, not one neighborhood, a whole town, only with 100 people living in. Sweden has just celebrated being 10 million people last year. So it's a very big country with a very small population, and people are spread everywhere. So you can be living in a neighborhood over the week or the weekend. You just find like 10, 20 people over the weekend who are walking in the street. So the isolation is a real issue here. Well, I think I have to go to my baby now. This is the first episode about the social aspect in Sweden. Stay tuned for the next episode. The next episode we're going to be talking about studying in Sweden, and if you want me to talk more about the social aspect in Sweden, about marriage and so, you can mention this below, or I can be doing mix and match next time. So thank you so much, stay tuned. Oh, and don't forget this. Yeah, did you know this idea of subscribing? Yeah, so you can get notifications about every video I'm going to be posting. And if you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumb up, and also share it to all your friends and family. And please, again, if you want me to be talking more about or the next episode about certain topic, just let me know, and maybe we can change the topic. Instead of speaking about some, discussing something about the education in Sweden or studying in Sweden, we can start to talk about another video. All these videos is for you, so I would love to be making everyone happy and enjoying the videos. Thank you so much. Hey though.